I'm Doug Doyle with the Art of the Story. By the early 80s, Chick Corea had already worked with Miles Davis, released numerous groundbreaking albums, and led various groups, including the popular and influential Return to Forever. Relentlessly creative as he would be for the rest of his life, Corea decided to assemble a new group that would reflect his latest explorations on the electric keyboard. The resulting Elektric band had a few different members initially, but soon settled on personnel that would stay together for the next 6+ years and would set a standard for contemporary jazz. John Patitucci on electric bass, Dave Weckl on drums, Eric Marienthal on alto saxophone, and Frank Gambale on guitar. During that period, the Elektric band released 7 albums and toured all over the world. Candid Records has released a box set from the Chick Corea Elektric Band, The Complete Studio Recordings, 1986 through 1991. WBGO's Lee Mergner recently spoke with Patitucci and Marienthal about Korea's outsized influence on their own lives and music.
So let's start with you, John. You remember the first time you heard Chick's music? Were you a Return to Forever guy?
No, the first thing I heard, well, it was Return to Forever, but the one with Joe Farrell and Stanley and Ayerto and Flora. I was a kid and I had a mentor, this guy, Chris Poehler, in the Bay Area. He made cassettes for me of some stuff, all kind of music. And one of them was the first record they did on ECM, which had La Fiesta, and Stanley played this open solo in the beginning of that. And then, of course, Light as a Feather. That was a huge thing in our house. We used to blast that record.
Clear days. So good, I'm free. So light as a feather can be.
That was a big deal. And then later on, you know, I did go to see RTF at Berkeley Community Theater in the Bay Area, San Francisco area. I saw the Romantic Warrior Tour, which had to be around 1975. It was just insane. Like, I was in high school. So that was my first real thing. And of course, then I got into all the other stuff later on.
How about you, Ark? Was that a similar thing? Or
it's hard to remember exactly which record. I remember it distinctly in high school, actually, when I probably right around the time I met John. And when I was a junior, our quartet was very acoustic. It was, you know, saxophone, piano, bass, and drums. And we were so into Return to Forever, we transcribed the entire Where Have I Known You Before record. Around the same time, 1976, I think, I went to Royce Hall at UCLA to hear Return to Forever. And it was mind-blowing.
You can hear the entire conversation with John Patitucci and Eric Marienthal at wbgo.org/music. I'm Doug Doyle, WBGO News.